Alright everyone, hello and welcome back to another episode of Autonauts then, with me, Spacefish, and welcome back to Automation Mania. We've got bajillions of bots zooming all over the place at this point, and last episode, we finally actually took care of getting some research going. As you can see right here, we're nicely generating away some colonist woof out here with our newly acquired colonists, and, we are feeding them nicely with some berries that we're getting from up here, and getting a bunch of colonist wolf that we're then using for research. We already got one thing out of the way in the last episode, which got us this crude blade, which we do now need for farming technology, which is kind of the next thing down the line at the moment in terms of technology, because we do want some crude hoes and crude scythes. After that, I think the idea hopefully is that we will sometime get some better tools. We actually need three technologies from level one complete, apparently, in order to move on to level two. And if we look very closely out here, I do not really see any improved tools. So I'm not really sure when those will actually come our way currently. I don't know. I'm really unsure. I mean, there's like some cool tools and stuff here, but I would really like some sort of actual usable mine bot tools that kind of get our usage rate of tools down a bit, if that is possible. That said, I don't see any of that anywhere close at the moment. This, oh wow, okay. So that is a while out. We will have to make do with this for a good bit of time then. Oh wow, okay. Also, I mean, the research costs are gonna increase crazily in a bit, so gotta keep that in mind. We also have huts, which I guess we can place the colonists in to get more colonist wolf or something? One way or another. I think the first thing that we will start out with here today is making, who would have thought it, another bot. So let's take care of that first. Maybe we should eventually get a bot that makes bots. Because, you know, we've got quite the high usage rate of those at the moment, I would argue. So maybe something to consider there for the future. Also, I need to rewind that little guy right there. Boop, there you go. And, that stone storage is nicely filling up, so that's beautiful. What do we need here? We need a tree seed, which I do not have that many of. No, there they are. We will put that right there, then we'll grab a pole from here and put that there too, and then we'll take care of things. And maybe we should also kind of look at robotics upgrades after this farming technology bit then. Before the start, I think that's the right way to go, because I don't want to give this bot a stick every 2 microseconds, basically. Now, first thing that we'll do, though, is we will teach this botsy right here how to feed our colonists. So, let's go over here, and did I just click the right button? I did. You will take 2 berries from the storage, my dude, and you will give those 2 berries to the nearest colonist you find, and, that's it. You've got 2KB free, which is perfect. Repeat. Stop recording. Stop recording. Stop recording. There we go. And get going. I hope that works, because that would mean that we now auto-generate colonist wealth instead of having to, you know, feed them all the time ourselves. So that would be beautiful. We are going to give this bot another stick, of course, because, well, why not? We're going to have to provide that there. Also, another thing that I just saw here. Is it, like, the case that if we don't remove the turf, the stuff actually grows over again, basically? Because that wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Like, I would love to just place a bit of turf here and... Oh, wait, we can just hop on that and... Oh, okay. I think... Wait, let me... Stop digging, please. We're gonna, release these bots from their duty then. And actually finish this farm finally, I hope. You stop. Okay, that didn't work as I intended to. Why is he... he's digging again. I gotta catch them in between work. Please. Stop teleporting yourself up front, please! Okay, I mean, he's technically out of energy now, which is a good thing, I guess. But then he's working again. Oh my god, how do I get these guys to stop now? Please, no, don't... Right, trash it all. There you go. Now stand around and don't do anything. Okay, now we do need to do that for the second guy. But after that, we should be able, if he stops... Why does he teleport? Please don't teleport. Please. Okay. I think you get what the plan is here, but we need to actually get these guys to stop what they're doing, which is harder of a task than I thought it was gonna be. Please stop. No. Yes. Thank you. You. Stop. Record. Trash it all. Stop. Thank you. You're just standing around now. Okay, so what the plan is then? We've got a huge ton of turf here, of course. And we also kind of discovered previously that... How did I do that just now? Oh, do the holes need to go first? I guess they do. Maybe we could just leave that lying down right here, because, like, this kind of just went back to the normal way it was before? Or maybe we need to fix those holes, but, I guess you see what the plan is for a start, right? We will, sort of kind of, take care of actually having this set up in rows of two instead of actually, well, having one row after another, because we, of course, previously discovered that that really doesn't quite work all too well for us. So, we're going to have to dig up a bit of turf here manually, and then I guess I will have to close the holes that are in the way of my plans, which sounds like an absolutely atrocious task to take care of, to be honest. But I would really like to sort out this farm once and for all without having to... continuously do, worry about losing berries and all that stuff. And also we're going to need more sticks, which we're going to have to provide for. Sticks, though, we do technically have in here, and, well, not too many of those. And all my bots are kind of out of order again, too, which is, of course, as usual, a great feeling. Absolutely nothing down here is working, because all the bots are missing their tools. And this is one thing that I'm still not too sure about, is like, if I can just somehow get the bots to give other bots their tools, basically. Because I'm not quite sure how that would work. Ooh, didn't know I could just pick up bots. Lol. I don't want to pick up the bot. I just want his tool, thank you. So yeah, I don't really know how that works, if that works, you know, it would be the ideal thing of me just being able to tell them, you know, go bot and pick up, like, a shovel and give it to whichever bot actually needs a shovel. I'm just really not quite sure if it works that way. So, you know, kind of concerned about that point, but we're going to need another shovel for ourselves for the time being. Which, by the way, we're kind of low on shovels, so we should probably actually get this guy going again. The other one with the axes I don't really care about. And it seems that the pile of axes actually has an end to it, which is good news, I would say. But we're going to quickly dig some holes right here, and then I'm kind of not sure. Do I really have to get rid of all those other holes that we don't need? Or how does that work? Because that sounds like a whole lot of work, which I don't really appreciate, but it feels like the way we will have to do things, especially because we have to eventually dig up those berry bushes too, I suppose. Is he whacking those without a stick right now? No, he isn't, right? No, he is. No, no, no. It just looked like it. Okay, so, I mean, we can have holes right here, because we do, of course, want to plant berry bushes right there. But, well, you kind of get the point, right? A lot of digging to be done. A lot of fixing things to be done as well. I am not going to make you spend all this time with me. Or actually, maybe I am, because I'm thinking I could, in theory, actually use my bots out here to help me fix things. Huh. If I'm thinking about it, that'll probably be the smarter move for me. So you. Come and record for a second. We're going to go... And one, two, fix this hole. move to hole and find, okay, yeah. And then we're just going to define like one row for him, basically. And once that row is done, we're going to unlearn him and do it for the next row, if that makes sense. So that way I don't have to run around for the next 2 bajillion years just digging up holes all by myself. My bots can do it for me, which I think is certainly the right way of doing things. So let's repeat that. You're going to get the tool and you're going to just go. So please do that for me. And then we've got one more bot which we can kind of task with the same thing, and that way, you know, that is hopefully gonna make things a whole lot easier for us. So then we've got two rows right here that we want to keep, and that one we want to kind of get rid of. So no, stop, don't dig, thank you. Botsy, did I not delete that stuff? Did I delete his stuff? No. I thought I deleted his task. Anyways, let's get rid of that. We are gonna go and in this row right here, remove the hole. And you're gonna do the same thing for me for this row. Then we're gonna have these two rows, and then that really doesn't quite work out the way that I wanted it to in terms of like actually being a 13-mo-1, so like, the area isn't quite as ideal as I wanted it to be, and we're probably not going to be able to perfectly use things, but on the upside, it actually works, you know, which I think is also already a bonus, given that otherwise we would just be losing all the berries that we harvest, which it doesn't sound like the best idea ever to me. So, you've got your task, you can get a shovel, and you can get going too. Now, what I can already do is actually pick up some of this stuff, and just go and... Yep. Okay, so we just needed the holes to be gone, basically. So we're gonna go and actually jump on top of that, get some turf actually worked into a soil, and, you know, fix up the patch a bit for ourselves, which is going to be very nice indeed. Now, then we've got this patch right here too, which we can already put these two in so that doesn't accidentally regenerate itself. And yes, you will get a stick, and then I will go and actually plant some berry bushes where they're supposed to be. Because, you know, that's a one-time thing. I don't think we're going to use a bot for that. We're going to quickly go around and actually finalize this huge thing that we've got going right here. I think, honestly, it probably makes sense now, like, looking at... Oh, yeah, right, I had a bot to actually recharge bots out here. But, you know, looking at things, I think it makes a lot more sense than I initially thought that my field for these berries is this huge. Because, well, you just all saw how much colonist wolf we really need. Right, like there's, I don't know, 1,500, 2,000, whatever, like insane amounts of colonist wolf out there that we really do need. And I'm quite happy that we are going to be able to cover that a bit better with a huge field like this. Also, we need to really, really rewind this bot, that's important. And this one maybe too. I hope that this one bot, by the way, can take care of two colonists. We'll kind of have to see about how efficient and fast he really is at doing these things, but that's just something we'll find out as we go. The recharging part is honestly kind of important, I would say, but we're going to have to see how we can do that, because there's a lot of area to cover in which to recharge that specific bot, so we'll have to see about that. But for now, let's just continue planting berries and all, and increasing our field size ever after, and yeah, then we'll kind of go from there. So this is going to be the second row. This all needs to be planted with berry bushes, of course, and then we can actually already reconfigure that one bot to take care of a different row for us, which we will quickly do. So you, buddy, we are going to go and edit your area of work. Now we've got 1, 2, and this row has to go, unfortunately, and then we can have the upper row to kind of top it off. Okay, so that row has to go. Please work on that one now. Thank you very much. And I will go and grab some of the turf from up here to actually go and, you know, fix what you did for us here. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And well, I mean, we're going to need more turf and there's going to be more patches to fix, but that's going to be beautiful. The other bot also being done in the meanwhile probably means that we can go and dig up the missing holes in just a second with him, because there's a few missing up here. And and then we'll kind of see where to go from there. You are missing a shovel. We'll take care of that in a minute. You will have to kind of... No, wait. Yes, actually. You will kind of have to relearn everything, because now you are actually going to dig up holes. So we've got 1, 2 rows right here that we actually want holes to be in, and we don't have holes in there everywhere currently. So what we're going to do is we're going to go here. We're going to dig up a hole. Dig, 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 and that's it. So, the area shall be this right here, and I know there's still turf right there that we kind of technically need to get rid of, so we'll have to find out about that one. But this is the area I want him to work in. You'll get to play, and you'll receive a shovel? Where did I just... Oh my god. Dude. Where did I just put the shovel? Did I put it inside of him? Oh my god. Okay, well, we need another shovel regardless, so we will quickly take care of that. And oh, whoa. Apparently that is not the max height. Why did he stop when he didn't? That's insane. This literally is like a shovel pile to the moon or something, but we'll give him this shovel so he hopefully moves away, and then I can grab the other shovel for the other dude, or not, you know. Until he moves away, we will go and place a bit of turf. And then he will hopefully have moved by then. So let's go and hop on all these things right here. And there's the missing shovel. Beautiful. Oh, that was weird. Okay, so all this turf here has to go. You will plunk that down right there. And we've got a tad bit more right there. We need another 3 pieces that we will go and place up here. And then that row is fixed as well, which is beautiful. And you can kind of see the farm starting to take a bit more shape, I think, and, you know, everything making a bit more sense. I think we will need another harvesting bot, to be honest, because we're a bit slow with that currently. Holy moly! Whoopsies! We definitely need a recharging bot for these dudes down here. Oh, boy. That is quite insane, I would argue. Please pick up all that colonist wealth. I hope it cannot despawn. We do need another axe, and we do not have any more axes, and we're not really making them, so I'm gonna have to actually make some of those myself. What are you doing, actually? I don't know what you're doing, but you're doing it again now. And yes, yes, I know that they're still all not working down there. It's... We kind of need to get them back to work, don't we? I mean, we don't really need that much wood, to be fair. Like, all the wood is full, but I do kind of need the sticks and all, which... if there's so many trees planted, you know, there could be an issue with that. Also, my recharging bot seems to be out of power, which is certainly a tad bit of an issue. Let's get him back to work, and let's give a shovel to that lad, and then... Well, you know... Then this operation can start back up again for the time being, and we'll get this pickaxe out to that guy. And we will certainly, certainly have to get a recharging bot out here. Holy moly, that's a lot of colonist wolf. That is insane, honestly. I'm just going to help that bot out for a quick second to make sure that, you know, none of that is hopefully going to despawn, but, you know. They're out of food. Oh, yeah, because you are not charged now. Oh, God. Yeah, we need a charging bot down there ASAP. We do also need another shovel. This whole tool thing is really kind of holding back. I have to say, I feel like that's one of the bigger issues we're having right now, but it's also one of the things where I'm not all too sure how I want to fix that, because I'm not sure that the logic works that way. But what we just got, actually, is the farming tools, which is beautiful indeed. Got a crude hoe, got a crude scythe, so... I mean, the hoe, I would think we don't need for the berries, but the scythe we could use to actually get them out of the bushes, I hope. Anyways, I would kind of like to work on the robotics technology, so that's what we're going to do for the time being. I want some more sophisticated robots that can take care of more tasks at once, if that makes sense. We're also going to quickly look into this, just to, you know, kind of click all these things once or something so that they go out of the way. Crude flail. Get straw and grain or for beating bush. Ah, okay, so this is for beating bushes then. And then that is... okay. I think we're gonna actually need, like, another table to make those, because we're gonna run through a lot of them, especially once I get two bots. Gonna actually make another one, I think. But, what I want to take care of first is actually spreading some turf up there. And, then probably digging up these holes and closing up those. Which is also another big task, and then we need to get rid of the berry bushes, but I kind of really want to get this farm in line for today, you know. Actually make sure that things work as they're intended to, and then we're going to take care of actually getting some proper tools for farming out to these spots and afterwards, basically. And, also some recharging bot for, like, the guys that feed the bots out here. Now, you know, the good thing is we've got still two bots remaining out here that after redesigning this whole farm will kind of be free. So we're probably just gonna get them to the task of also farming and collecting berries out here, and that'll hopefully amp up our efforts a bit to actually, you know, make enough food, because currently this little guy right here is actually feeding more than we're generating in terms of berries, I think. So, well, quite interesting right there. Now you, though. I would like to relearn things with you, so please give me that spade for a quick second. You're gonna go here. You're gonna dig up turf. And once that turf is dug up in 2 bajillion years, you're gonna be happy and repeat. Now we're gonna have to reallocate your area of work, of course, and we're gonna make it this beautiful. And play and spade. Did I just drop that on the ground again? Oh my god, please, no. I'm really annoyed about that, not gonna lie. We're gonna give him a new spade, and then we're gonna use that spade to actually do some work ourselves, I suppose. Despite that being somewhat annoying of an issue. But that way, you know, we can get that road done too. And, well, then only this one here will be remaining, which we can probably honestly take care of ourselves too if we really wanted to, which I don't know if I really want to. In the meanwhile, shall we get a new bot going that will recharge other bots? I think we shall. So let's go and actually recharge this one here. Because I think that's the stone bot, yeah? He always runs out of energy in the weirdest locations. But we will go and actually grab some stuff to make one more bot. And then once one of those, like, feeding bots or research bots or someone out there runs out of energy, we can actually teach that bot what to do. Because we'll, of course, have to wait to be able to perform that action to tell them what action to do. And then, you know, this part here should be out of our responsibility zone too, which should be nice. One less thing to take care of, basically. So, there goes a new boy. We're gonna just recharge him for the time being, not do anything with him. And then we're gonna go and actually pick up some sticks that we will kind of proceed to give this guy up here a few of. Just to ensure that he's gonna be able to continue farming. There goes the first one out of energy. I'm not sure the area that this bot can serve is big enough to actually go from here all the way to down there. But we'll try. This guy here is also out of energy, so we can start with that one. And then we will see. Like, this has to be the bottom corner about of where he starts to recharge. And yeah, it's kind of what I suspected the issue was going to be. Like, we've got to start here, because if a bot runs out right at the crate, he needs to be recharged. And up here, he's kind of slightly out of range, so it's not ideal. There is potentially places where our bots will not be able to be recharged by that other bot, but mostly we've got everything covered now, which is a start, you know, and if we find some issues in between, we'll just have to take care of it ourselves. Now, shovel here, we will put right there for the time being. We've got all this turf here that we do, of course, need to get out of the way, so we'll put that aside right there for the time being. We'll get this out of the way, put that aside as well, and then we will grab this guy right here. Wait, are there two standing inside of each other? Of course there are. We have currently got move to soil. We will have to relearn that, so give me a spade for a second, buddy. You will go here, and you will finish these holes for me for a quick second. So please, do that. Boom, done. The area of work that you're going to take care of is going to be this one right here, and then you're going to repeat, you're going to get going, and I'm going to give you your spade back, if I may. Now I can. Okay, cool. Now, this guy up here, we're also going to have something for you. We are going to go trash these things, we're going to go grab your shovel, you're going to go and dig up a berry bush. And get rid of said berry bush. Holy moly, that takes long. Good thing that I'm actually giving that to a bot. I didn't think that was going to take that long. But yeah, so you're going to get rid of all berry bushes you find in this area of work. You're going to go and repeat that, and you're going to get going. And please complain about not having a shovel. There you go. There's your shovel. Beautiful. Now, another stick for this guy right here, which is something we will absolutely have to change ASAP. And we're going to go, well, and ideally plant some more berry bushes if we had more berries to plant them with. Wow, we're out. That's insane. That is pretty insane, honestly. We will need more harvesting dudes, which shouldn't be the hardest thing in the world because all my digging bots are now done with their jobs. So that's a start, but still, you know, still gonna have to re-teach them those things in just a second. But, you know, the good thing is that basically our farm has now taken the shape we always wanted it to take. We've kind of made space in between the rows so that all the berry bushes will have their berries fall somewhere where they don't get lost. And, yeah. You know, everything is properly redesigned. Now we just need to actually get the bots to harvest some things on, well, instead of, you know, digging up all the holes. So we're going to repurpose them for that. I think one for harvesting and one for collecting. And then we will probably actually go and get another table here going for the new farming tools. And we'll get the farming tools transported up here so that we can more easily give them out to the bots. So, quite a lot of plans there for the future, and our research is also going along nicely, of course. Already 65 colonists wove into the next robotics upgrade. Very much looking forward to that. For today, we're going to end it off right here with the farm finally taking its final shape, so very much happy with that, except for a berry bush missing right there. However, that just happened, so we'll have to fix that. But other than that, very, very happy with that. I hope you all are too. If you are, please make sure to leave a like down below. That always does help out a ton with discoverability on YouTube, and if you're new around here and haven't done so just yet, also please consider subscribing right down below, as well as hitting that bell icon to stay up to date on all the future upcoming episodes. But with all those things out of the way, as usual everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I hope I will catch you in the next episode very, very soon. Ciao.